ride to Martin Ag Service to pick up coal. We burn anthracite nut coal. We pick it up in bulk. Not by the bag, but in bulk, and bring it home. Sometimes we use the mini truck, which is in another video on the channel. Other times we use the big truck. The mini truck has a dump bed on it, so it can dump out. This one we have the cargo unloader, which we'll show you later in the video. But how this works here, they have a scale you go over, get your empty weight, you get loaded, and then they have you go back over the scale again at the end to calculate how much weight you have. So here we are pulling into the place now. We'll show you the process as we go. Go over the scale here, we'll get our empty weight. Over in the building, there's a weight there, 7300. Wait for the green light, and she'll signal us to go down below. See the green light yet?
There it is.
Alright. There's a dump truck loading up. We're going to load it right there. It's a conveyor belt. It screens it, and then they have water that'll spray it to wash it off. And over there they have the bins. Blashak is the brand. That's the mining company that they get from.
I'm taking video of it too, because it's really interesting and everything. Not many people, there's not many videos and stuff of like coal stoves and stuff. And
exactly.
So. So I fold the tarp over in the center there, so that when I unroll it, half of it comes out at a time. Over there, there's the washers on it. He's gonna load up. Thank you.
lot of coal.
And that's some sort of like paraffin oil or something?
Yeah, it's a mineral.
Mineral oils. Yeah, I store it in 5 gallon buckets. I actually have a small coal bin I made out of an IBC tote.
Okay.
That I cut it in half so it's low enough so I can just back this up to it and,
and just
fill it right into that.
Right, so
I'm sure I'll lose some oil over the time because it's outside. I'll tarp it, but
right, yeah.
I think it'll help.
Yeah, it definitely will. Standard rate like this, you should figure about half a year.
Okay.
That's inside, so if you're outside, you're going to lose a little more. But.
Yeah, I wasn't sure if it's worth having or not, but I figured I'd.
Yeah.
Might as well.
Yeah, I think you'll like it. I mean, it's.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't empty the ash inside anymore. I carry the pan outside. Because the dust from coal ash is so much more fine.
Yeah, it just
gets
everywhere.
Yeah, so.
Over the scale. So we're back on the scale, we're at 10.020.
So I got these IBC totes here. Open the tailgate like that. Hopefully I can crank it into this. We'll see how it goes. Thank you. time doing this. We have a lot spilled out on the sides. Just made this bin out of one IBC 2 that I cut in half. Drilled holes in the bottom of it so I can drain. I'll tarp it. So I had some spillage there. The Mini would have worked better because it's narrower and it wouldn't spill off on the edges inside the truck. I got up in there and shoveled some of those edges, but as you can see, I got some here in the edges I still need to deal with. But it sure beats shoveling it out by hand. So now I'll do this by hand and then continue on. So I shoveled out the rest of the coal into buckets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 buckets. There's a couple in there already from the past. At least a bucket or two came from spilled area where I just hand picked it out. It all spilled here. What I ended up doing is I turned these top blocks sideways now that I know. If I use the big truck, it's too wide and a lot of it spills off to the sides. Hopefully having them sideways, it won't fill up into the cavities of it, which it did. These front ones I'll turn after they're not frozen to the ground and after I don't have them filled with coal. It was 2,700 pounds, if I remember correctly. Filled these bins and however many buckets. What I'm going to do is shovel the rest of this off the top into a few more buckets here so it's not as heapingly tall.